The Rich Rabbit.
Emporio Armani was founded in 1975 by Giorgio Armani, one of the most influential and celebrated fashion designers from Italy. Armani provides quality, sophisticated, and timeless style clothing ranging from luxury garments, apparel, jewelry, and aftershaves. The company describes themselves as providing quality, sophistication, and style timeless values with global appeal. Giorgio Armani was born on 11th of July 1934 and along with his brother and sister grew up in the industrial town of Piacenza in northern Italy, which was bombed repeatedly during the World War II. His sister Rosanna told Newsweek's Christopher Dickey that Armani spent 40 days in the hospital when he was burned by a flare a classmate had found on the street. The Armanis moved to Milan in 1949. Armani went to medical school for 2 years, but dropped out in 1957 to take a job as a buyer for the La Rinascente department store, a job he held for about 7 years. He then worked as a fashion designer for hitman Nino Cerruti's men's clothing company before establishing himself as a freelance designer in 1970. Armani formed his own company, Giorgio Armani, on 24th of July, 1975, at the suggestion of his enthusiastic partner, Sergio Galliotti. One story retold in Forbes has the pair selling their used Volkswagen for startup capital. Another version, in a later edition of Forbes, puts the startup figure at $100,000. The first products were ready-to-wear clothes for men and women. The company was successful from the beginning. First year sales were $1 million. In 1978, a licensing agreement with Gruppo Finanziario Tessile, or GFT, allowed Armani to invest in a new headquarters building. The building, a 17th century palazzo at 21 Via Borgonovo, Milan, would house not only offices, but a theater for fashion shows, as well as Armani's personal residence. Armani would be credited for inventing the Italian fashion industry, particularly in Milan. The next year, 1979, saw the establishment of the Giorgio Armani Corporation in the United States. Giorgio Armani would be counted among the world's leading fashion houses by the end of the decade. Part of the success was due to Armani's bold design gambles, which developed a more casual chic by such touches as removing padding from the traditional men's suit jacket. Women's clothes were made more comfortable and less showy. Other designers and knockoff artists would copy the look, but the original retained a dedicated following. The collection by this time had already been expanded to include several new lines such as Manni, Armani Jr., and underwear and swimsuits. Armani and Emporio Armani brands of jeans were launched in the early 80s, a decade known for its designer jeans. Emporio Armani was a lower-priced version of the flagship line. Boutiques for both the brands were soon opened in Milan. Giorgio Armani was one of the first designers to exploit the marketing power of media stars. He began a long relationship with Hollywood when he designed Richard Gere's wardrobe for the 1980 film American Gigolo. A string of other movie credits would accumulate throughout the next 2 decades, including Batman and Pulp Fiction and, appropriately, Ready to Wear. Armani was also responsible for much of the pastel wardrobe for the stars of Miami Vice, the hit TV series of the late 80s. Armani sponsored or provided wardrobes for the musical tours of several pop musicians, including Paul Simon, Billy Joel, David Bowie, and Eric Clapton. Galliotti, Armani's partner and the one who had handled the day-to-day management, died of AIDS in 1985 and left Armani his 50% interest in the firm. Armani subsequently surprised some observers with his business sense. He immediately set out to expand the Emporio Armani line beyond jeans. In the next 6 years, Emporio sales increased from $75 million to $209 million. a variety of new enterprises proliferated in the last half of the 80s. The first Armani Junior store opened in Milan in 1986. Giorgio Armani Japan, a joint venture with Japanese Itochu Corporation, was created in 1987. The first Emporio Armani Express restaurant opened in London as the 80s drew to their inevitable cross-branding conclusion. Giorgio Armani also opened the restored Doni Bistro in Florence in 1989. On another front, Emporio Armani magazine had begun publishing in January of the same year. Armani turned down a 1989 takeover offer by the Jean Lorouin design house. Luxury conglomerates Gucci and LVMH would also offer to buy out Armani. While competitors Prada and Gucci expanded through expensive acquisitions of other luxury brands, Armani preferred to tighten its control on the production and marketing of its products. The company began buying shares in its manufacturers, including Antinia and Intai, in 1989 and 1990. Antinia had gross sales of $25 million and made women's clothes for the Emporio Armani brand. Intai, maker of Armani ties, grossed $16 million a year. A Forbes cover story in October 1991 noted Giorgio Armani's meticulous attention to detail throughout his fashion empire. Armani's small group of intensely loyal advisors, including his sister Rosanna, held board meetings with the passion of an Italian family argument. The first Armani Exchange store, also known as AX, opened in New York's Soho district in 1991. The Exchange sold $90 jeans and $75 t-shirts, costly enough for weekend clothes, but much less pricey than the Armani boutique's dress clothes. The clothes and stores were licensed to the US division of Cement, a publicly traded company based in Modena, Italy, in which Armani held a 20% interest. Bloomingdale's, Saks Fifth Avenue, Neiman Marcus, and other US department store chains together opened another 24 or so AX sections within their stores in 1992. Despite initial projections of opening up to 150 freestanding AX stores, the venture had begun to falter by 1994, when the chain had 41 outlets, resulting in a huge loss for Cement. The Economist blamed the large royalty, usually 10%, which went to the designer for each garment sold. Cement sold the AX chain to Ong Beng Sung, a Singapore-based company, for $12.5 million in June 1994. Armani later pursued the strategy of maintaining a very small number of these lower-priced outlets to maintain the brand's allure as well as the profit margins he expected. In fact, Armani was unique among brands in limiting the maximum amount of business its licensees could each generate. Alitalia hired Armani to design new outfits for its flight attendants and the interiors of its MD-11 airliners in the early 1990s. The firm also designed the uniform for Italy's 1994 Football World Cup team and those for Britain's Newcastle United team in 1999. In 1996, Armani opened two stores in Manhattan, one an Emporio Armani store and the other the four-story flagship of the chain. The first Collezione Giorgio Armani stores opened in Milan, London and Tokyo in 1997. The same year, the first Armani jeans store opened in Rome and Armani watches were also introduced. July 1997 was marked by the murder in Miami of Armani's fiercest rival in Milan, the flamboyant Gianni Versace. The next month, Armani was reported to be considering either taking his company public or taking in a partner, and the Armani Group underwent reorganization. Police cancelled an Emporio Armani fashion show in Paris on 12th of March 1998, citing security concerns. To some, this affront seemed rather to be a sign of the long-standing rivalry between the French and Italian fashion industries. The Armani Group continued to roll out new categories of products. An accessories division was created in 1999. The first accessory store would open in Milan 2 years later. Also in 1999, Armani entered e-commerce with ArmaniExchange.com and bought two menswear factories from its longtime licensee, GFT. Consolidated revenue rose 12% in 1999, though net income fell 12%, largely due to taxes on a sale of shares held in Luxottica. In 2000, Armani posted operating profits of 374 billion lira on consolidated net revenues of 2 trillion lira, which were up 20% for the year. Global retail sales exceeded 7 trillion lira. During 2000, the company launched a joint venture with the Zegna Group called Tremel to produce and distribute the Armani Collezione line of men's clothing. Soon afterwards, Giorgio Armani Cosmetics debuted. Armani Casa, a home fashion store, opened after years of planning. A series of Armani-related websites were launched and plans for a new headquarters office were underway. During the year, Armani was honored with an exhibit at New York's Guggenheim Museum for changing the way people dressed in the previous quarter century. At this stage in his career, Armani was finding inspiration in the marriage of Eastern minimalism and Western luxury. The billionaire designer also honored himself in 2000 by opening a three-level, $73 million megastore in Milan called Armani. I just wanted to give a present to myself on my 25th anniversary, he said at the opening. The store carried not just clothes, but flowers, books, food, especially sushi, and home furnishings. The company was hit by the departure of several key executives, including managing director Giuseppe Brozzone, who had been with Armani for 15 years. He was later appointed to the CEO spot at Donna Karan International, a unit of LVMH. In 2001, Giorgio Armani announced plans for a joint venture with Vestimenta, one of its earliest licensees, to produce and distribute its top line of men's and women's clothes. Armani was also acquiring control of its Hong Kong retail network from Joyce Boutique Holdings Limited. Armani continued to resist the trend towards consolidation in the luxury goods industry. Over the years, Armani continually added new offerings to his company, introducing perfume, accessories, a jeans line, the lower-priced diffusion line Emporio Armani, sportswear, and a limited edition line of handmade couture dresses. In 2001, the Guggenheim Museum in New York City presented a major retrospective of Armani's work. In 2002, Armani was appointed Goodwill Ambassador for the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees. He designed the uniforms for the Italian flag bearers participating in the 2006 Winter Olympics opening ceremony, as well as those of various professional athletic teams, including England's Chelsea Football Club and Australia's Rabbitohs. In 2007, Armani partnered with the electronics giant Samsung to create a luxury LCD television and cellular phone as part of an expansion of his consumer lifestyle product line. That same year, his Armani Privé Spring-Summer Collection fashion show was broadcast worldwide via Microsoft Corporation's MSN web portal, as well as singular cellular phones. This made him the first clothing designer to broadcast an haute couture fashion show live on the internet. Giorgio Armani, who once used to work at the departmental store in Milan, has a net worth close to $9 billion. This is the power of an idea. That's what dreams are capable of. If you like our videos, subscribe to Rich Rabbit and don't forget to click the bell icon, as we have plenty of more interesting videos coming your way.